Howdy folks, and welcome back to Let's Play Pillars of Eternity, as per usual, brought to you by my amazing supporters over on Patreon. And today, I guess we're gonna unlock this Selkie. Well, unlock this great, not the Selkie, we're using the Selkie. Hey guys, how you doing? Oh, thank you. I never thought we'd get out of there.
Are you hurt?
No, just a little bruised, perhaps. The cold was the worst part. I bet on Bless Your Blade, I thought that madman would kill us all. The commander wasn't the problem. One of the delegates points an accusing finger at another, a woman standing apart from the rest. We'd have come to terms if she hadn't goaded him, shouting at him about omens and curses, demanding he leave the march. You know how superstitious the Red Serens are. The commander went white as a sheet. She sabotaged the meeting. The woman in question is dressed in an unassuming robe. She bears the accusation silently, her eyes closed as if in prayer. We'll ask her,
who are you?
With desperate speed, the woman suddenly lunges sidelong towards a nearby rack and sees a dagger lying there. She sets the blade to her own throat. Seriously? So this was intentional then. Unseated all but yourself, the dying woman's soul coils and thin wisps about her body. It only grows brighter as her corpse stills. The remaining delegates stale in horror. Stale stare in horror at her pooling blood. Manaha kneels by the dying woman and inspects her robes. She examines a crescent medallion hanging around her neck. Oh, is she one of the frickin'... What just happened? Damn it, now we'll never get an answer out of her. Let's read the woman's soul. You reach out and brace against a sudden flare of pain and fear. Digging after less recent events, there's a copper taste in your mouth and pain like fire in your throat. Under the brute terror of death, you find a comforting thread of resolve, of satisfaction and duty fulfilled. You follow it. It leads you stumbling into another memory. As whole and vivid as the first, you walk the dark halls of an abbey, dimly lit and quiet, your footsteps loud. A blur, and you are standing in a dimly lit room facing a robed Aumua. You recognize him as Kauto, the High Abbot. He beckons you forward. We examine our surroundings. You're in a wide, rounded chamber. The tiles beneath your feet are covered in strange curling symbols. You recognize them as symbols of Andra, goddess of sea and memory. The memory blurs. When your sight is clear, you're standing in front of Kauto, and he is smiling gently down at you.
Drive the raid series from these mountains, and you may yet spare many lives. The Tidebringer will be here in a week's time. Should you be delayed in your travels, report to him as you would to me. He will enter the reliquary and call off the army of Ilus in my stead. If you are caught, sister, you know what you must do. I will pray for your return, but we will take comfort in the knowledge that you have joined the rest of Andra's favored in her keeping.
The words jar you loose from the memory, flinging you back to the moment of the woman's death, and then into your own skin. The traces of her memory join yours. You know the path to the abbey to which she was returned, to return, buried in the mountains at the north.
She was a follower of Andra, a fanatic.
There was something about her that didn't seem right. Please, you're as surprised as the rest of us.
Do you know anything about an abbey to the north?
I've heard of something like that, an Andrite stronghold, not the kind of place that welcomes visitors. Manaha's eyes widen. That sounds like the Abbey of the Fallen Moon. Is that where she came from? The delegate points at the dead woman.
Yes, and it's where I'll find the reliquary so I can call off their army.
What, another one? Gods, it feels like everyone on Aeora is after the battery now. Why do these Andorites want Red Serens out? I doubt it's for Stalwart's benefit. Competition, maybe?
Well, I'd better go ask them.
You do mean to go to this abbey, be careful. There have been stories about traitors wandering north and getting scared off or even killed by strange guards. That's the place, all right. You're a secretive bunch. Suppose you could always try to sneak in? Doubt you'll be welcome otherwise. Sounds like this Tidebringer would be welcome, I mean.
Alright. Skulking around really isn't my style.
Well, you get your fill of fighting, I'm shit. A sudden deafening crash from outside makes the delegates jump. Startled, a rumbling like thunder follows. You hear further sounds of smashing timbers, panic screaming.
Oh no, what's that?
That's somebody fucking firing on us? Is the battery firing on us?
Oh no, what happened? What's happening? I thought you took care of the soldiers. I did. This is something else.
Yes, well, we'll wait here, inside.
Right.
Oh, this is gonna get violent. We're gonna quick save here. Oh, nice. I appreciate that effect, like the dust and shit dropping down from the ceiling, that's pretty cool. Nice touch. A for effort. Alright. Take a quick drink of my water, and we are good to go. After the loading screen, naturally. Oh! What in the hell? Eyeless hammers. Alright. And they've conveniently put my casters in front, naturally. Actually.
Hey.
There. Okay. I don't know what to expect from these guys. Wow, all right. Punting the Devil of Karak. A pretty impressive distance there. That's okay. Some kind of like Lord of the Ringsy music going on here. Wow, some nice damage to the front row. I'm really not too particularly worried, all things considered. I'm pretty confident in my melees. Oh, these things appear to be pretty beefy. So I guess we'll start dropping some buffs. That's a single target. Like, I don't know what I should be hitting these guys with, that's a thing. So I don't necessarily... He's not gonna be able to drop a... And Wall of Fire really doesn't do enough damage. Yeah, let's see if we can maybe slow him. Devil of Karak, you could, you know, get up on your feet. Thank you, anytime. Healing chain we don't need. Yeah, let's try this. Adair is like soloing this one. I'm not worried about him at all. I'm just waiting for, I'm waiting for the Devil of Karak to get back on her feet so she can come up here and start beating the absolute hell out of it. All right, so they're all prone. That's not good. Let's drop a big heal. They're taking some damage. No. These guys are surprisingly resilient. I'll take it, you know? Alright, so we've got a good defense buff on us. Where is... This is what we want. Damage bonuses for my melees and penalties for them. Let's see. She's gonna cast that there. Let's have... There. Now she should be in the AoE too. Beautiful. And we're just gonna have Adair keep lobbing lightning bolts into these guys. Yeah, I mean, like, look at that. With the Devil of Karak beating on this thing, like, she's just chewing through this thing's hit points. I think we've probably got this, honestly. So I don't necessarily know how much more I need my back row to do. We got freebie magic missiles and stuff. Woo! Good hit. Drop another big heal. Devil of Karak's prone and probably gonna be hurting here momentarily. Alright, one of them's down. I think we got this. I'm not worried. I'm gonna have to drink a potion or something, but yeah, we got this. As last of the mage folk falls, a tide of essence sweeps through the aether. As it washes over you, you find yourself in the memories of the eyeless. Alright, we got a bunch of experience points. Hulking creatures surround you, their sinewy wrapped skeletons clanking and screeching in the semi-darkness. Their bodies fill the air with the tang of metal and the musk of sweat. The cavern in which you stand, it looks like a cavern anyways, glows with a dim ambient light. Steel flashes as the eyelids shift and stir. They stamp their feet and groan in rasping metallic voices. Their restless energy prickles at the back of your neck. And in the echoing rumble, you hear something familiar. It's the pounding noise from your dream, the harbinger of a terrible army. You begin to wonder how many islets are crowded around you. Suspect there must be scores of them, maybe more. It's difficult to tell how far back this chamber goes or where it is. Ahead you see a glint of light. It might be an exit. However, the vision is already starting to fade. Let's explore further into the chamber. You push past the lumbering islets and cling to the wilting shreds of their vision. The cavern broadens before you. It swells with echoes until you hear the growling, grounding sounds of the islets all around. You pull yourself into a glowing crystalline outcropping and survey the expanse of blunt heads and piston arms. There aren't scores of them, there are hundreds. The vision ends, returning you to the frozen and blood-churned mud of the fort.
You don't mess around when you make enemies, do you?
I don't.
If only Galvino could see those. He'd die of envy. Or crushing.
Alright, so we got some vessel flesh and a bunch of copper. And Monaha wants to talk.
Yeah.
So we'll do that. Hey Monaha, what is up?
I guess we should be flattered that someone sent those things after us. But I would have preferred a card.
She whips a slick of gore from her neck, sniffs at her blood-streaked hand, and shrugs.
I'd heard rumors of the Eyeless, but I always thought that name was a metaphor. Though, I would have called them Mace Hands of Doom, if anyone had asked me.
We'll nod non-committally.
So this is the mysterious army you've been dreaming about, huh? It's a wonder you're getting any sleep.
That's why we're going to the Abbey, to stop them.
I'm regretting all of my decision-making up to this point. Still, I guess a suicidal plan is better than none.
Something on your mind?
Well, knowing that I'm finally close to getting rid of this memory, it feels like it's crowding my head that much more.
She paces and locks her fingers into her hair.
It's been with me for decades. Driven me halfway across the known world.
She throws her hands up.
And?
She stops pacing and sighs.
It's time I told you what I did.
Take your time. Actually, no, we'll just listen.
It was a war. Centuries ago, before Adirin unification.
She folds her hands in front of herself.
I was a soldier then. Led a campaign across the northern forests to subdue some of the outlying Kalklin villages. Brutal work.
Go on.
Lost a third of my forces to the forest, and another third to the elven scouts hiding in it. By the time we reached the first village, we'd crushed their defenses, and they'd bled us.
She shakes her head.
Wasn't much more than children and the elderly left, but they spit on us when we marched into town.
A scowl twists her face. Her eyes are cold.
The village elders surrendered and offered us lodging in the old meeting hall. And when the sun set, they tried to burn it down around us. They barely got a flame going, but that wasn't the point.
Yeah.
You had to make an example of them.
In their defiance, I saw months more of pointless, bloody battle as we fought for the rest of the region. I had to break them. And I had to send a message to the rest of the villages.
Her hands shake as she raises them to cover her face.
So I nailed every last one of them to the trees around the town and left them there to die.
That's pretty dark.
What happened then?
I never remembered more.
She shrugs.
Eventually, Adir and Kalklin united. The gentlefolk forgave each other for what they'd done to each other's people.
It wasn't you, Monaha.
So I've tried to tell myself. Anyway, we should get going.
She shoulders her pack and you catch a glimpse of something unusual in it, a thick roll of cloth bound by leather. Leather?
What's that?
Something I've been saving for better days.
She tucks it away.
Let's go.
Alright, we won't press. Goldleaf, how are you not leveled? Jesus Christ. Woman, I swear. Alright, well... Oh, Skulls from Mother is done. Somewhere in the deep ruins of Ibril's Well, a pair of Puigredrellan travelers... Alright, we've already read that. Zawa explored the ruins of Ibril's Well extensively and found a wide array of dangers in the ancient city's crumbling homes and places. Though the Puigred had always been hostile to outsiders, Zawa was able to speak with them and realized they were being mentally controlled by someone else. The source of the increased attacks was an Orlan Cypher who had been disowned by her father and subsequently banished from the Twice-Split Arrows. Especially skilled at mental domination, the Cypher was using the Puigwa, her children, to make a small fortune on unlucky travelers. However, once Zawa drew her out into the open, the overconfident Cypher was quickly defeated. In the Cypher's lair near the heart of Iberl's Well, Zawa discovered a grisly treasure, a necklace the Pwygwr had formed from the teeth of the Orlan's murdered father. Nice. And we have Father's Teeth. Grants Rot Skulls, 4 charges, and plus 18 for... Wow, that's actually pretty good. Rot Skulls. Summon weapon, Rot Skull. Alright. Looks like... So it's a ranged weapon that does some damage with some AoE crowed. Wow, that's actually a... That's actually a really good weapon. Sadly, it only has 4 charges, so I'm never going to use it. Huh. Alright, well, that's cool. Get out of here. Go ahead and skedaddle. Back to town. I saw some journal updates to the Iron Flail specifically. Alright, so this is just, hey, go to them. Find out how to call off the army and travel to the Abbey of the Fallen Moon. Okay, I don't think we really need to go to town necessarily, so I think we're just gonna head on out. Apparently missed some loot. That is a valuable Elder Wolf Fang. I will not leave it behind. It's an Abbey of the Fallen Moon. All right, 15 hours. Wow, that's a hell of a walk through snowy landscape. Delicious water. It is like 95 degrees outside, so that's some nice ass water. Long Bosque. All right, I'm gonna save, actually. It's been a while since we saved. Go ahead and quick save. Who are you? A dwarf clothed in but a few straps of fur puffs up his bare chest with every drag from his pipe. Come a long way to get some air, have you? What are you doing here? During the fine weather, just a bit longer. He smiles, letting a cloud of smoke and frosted breath escape through his teeth. My mistress had business with the Andrites. We'll be off soon as she's done at the Abbey. Meantime, I was told to stay put. They don't want any outsiders meandering about. Sherry put some kind of hex on me, says I won't even remember any of this, but the copper's worth it. Says I'll wake up at home with a full coin purse, opposite of most of my mornings, so that I had a certain appeal. Tell me about your mistress. Which one? He lets out a chuckle and slaps his chest, a reddening print blooms on his skin. Wish she were the fun kind. She's a gift bearer, paid me well to guard her on the journey, though. I'm looking to get inside. Are you now? He pulls the pipe from his clenched teeth and points its long stem at the path ahead. Far as I know, straight this way, middle path on the right, with the ruined arch, if they let you in, of course. Andrites are not too friendly, but to each their own. My mistress went through the archway, spoke to some guards there, then headed on. He bites down on his pipe with a sour expression. You get eyes on the other paths. Cast me dirty looks from afar when they pass this way, he grunts. As if I'd stand here in plain view if I had some grand design of sneaking into their blazing church. And what's an abbey got with that's worth hiding anyways? Monks? He grunts again and shakes his head and mutters something about if he were younger.
Why are you helping me?
He shrugs. You gotta look about you. Look like you need it. And maybe there's something I don't like about this place. Like it's hiding something. My younger days it'd be me going in there.
Do you know of other ways into the abbey?
No, but it's an abbey, not a fortress. You can bet it's got holes, like any fat old monster. Supply passages, escape routes. He shrugs as if it were a matter of course. I'd be lying if I said I'd ever explored one uninvited when I was too young to know better, helped myself to its relics. Let's just say if a certain war goddess has her way, I'll be living my next life as a dung roll bug.
Farewell.
Doubt we'll meet again. Any luck, my mistress will return soon. Hope you find what you're looking for. Alright. Grab this. Well, I mean, we could just go straight forward and
imagine a whole sect living out here. But I guess that's the point.
Alright, so in doing this, we got 2400 experience points, which leveled Gold Leaf, which I'm incredibly pleased with because new level of spells! And I guess a class ability. Oh wow, she can get Iconic Projection as. Oh, Spell Mastery. For some reason, I thought these were class abilities. I'm like, these look familiar. Honestly, I'm probably gonna go with Iconic Projection, because that's what we're good with. So what kind of spells we get? Cleansing Flame, hurl a ball of holy fire at the enemy that purges its protections to speed. It's, wow, that's 114 damage over 6 seconds. Nice. Plus 100% damage over time tick rate. So does that mean that this is, it says 114, but if it's plus 100% damage, that should be 229 change. And it jumps to 2 targets. This could be a really good spell. Crowns for the Faithful. AoE grants perception, resolve, and intellect. Eh. Minor intercession. Eh. Prayer against treachery. Immunity to charmed and dominate. That could be pretty useful. For 25 seconds, that could be really useful. Spark the souls of the righteous. Ignites a powerful zeal within allies that manifests an aura that shocks enemies near them. That could be handy. Litany against afflictions and her iconic projection. All right, I'll take it. Not bad spread of spells there. More good than bad. But we are at 21 minutes, so I'm going to go ahead and save it here. And next time we're probably going to be getting the crap kicked out of us by giant, well, priests, if I had to guess. I don't know if they're necessarily going to throw any more of those hammer guys at us in, you know, the short term. We'll see. That is then, this is now, though. So as per usual, thank you for watching. I hope you had a good time, and I will catch you all next time when the adventure continues. Till then, take it easy.